everybody. Welcome to the sixth edition of Rock the Word 153. My name is Father John Zagarella. I'm a Norbertine at Daylesford Abbey. And today is August 28th. And August 28th is a very special day for the Norbertines. It's the day when most of us were received into the order and received the habit, the white habit of the Norbertines. It's usually the day when we're simply professed and solemnly professed. And why is that? Well, we Norbertines follow the rule of St. Augustine. And August 28th is the feast of St. Augustine. And so today is a very special day for the Norbertine community. And I'm very happy to be bringing you Rock the Word 153 on this very special day for the Norbertine community around the world. Every Norbertine around the world celebrates the solemnity of St. Augustine, and so it is a very special day for us. And so one of the things that I wanted to talk to you about was about St. Augustine and the importance that he placed on friendship. I may have mentioned this in another edition of Rock the Word 153, but I think it bears repeating, that for Augustine, friendship was a non-negotiable. You really couldn't be on a spiritual journey without friends. He'll say that in life, two things are necessities, God and friends. So today I'd like to talk to you about St. Augustine, and I'd like to talk to you about his special emphasis on friendship. And the song that comes to mind on this Feast of St. Augustine is a song that came out in 1975 on the album A Night at the Opera. Of course, I'm talking about Queen and their song, You're My Best Friend. Now, of course, also on that album was the behemoth, Bohemian Rhapsody. But I'm not going to talk about that song. I'm going to talk about You're My Best Friend, which was another single off that record, nowhere near as successful as Bohemian Rhapsody, but I think it's a song that's very familiar to us. So the song You're My Best Friend comes to mind when I think about Augustine and friendship, because the song beautifully speaks about the rewards of friendship. And Augustine will say things like, when I come home from being away and I see my friend, my heart leaps for joy. And when I'm sorrowful and when I have a heavy heart, my friend shares my burden. You know, so a more popular way of saying it is that friendship doubles our joy and divides our grief. Now, I don't think Augustine really said that, but in his writings, that sentiment certainly came out. And in this Queen song, You're My Best Friend, those kind of sentiments are sung beautifully, of course, by the late Freddie Mercury. He sings, whatever this world can give to me, it's you, you're all I see. You make me live. You're my best friend. I've been with you such a long time. You're my sunshine, and I want you to know my feelings are true. I really love you. You're my best friend. You make me live. And further down in the song, he says, I've been wandering around, but I still come back to you. In rain or shine, you've stood by me. I'm happy at home. You're my best friend. And so if we have a best friend, if you have a best friend, call that friend to mind. And you know that when you're with your best friend, you really are at home. You can be who you are. You can be yourself. And you know that your friend is going to be there, whether you're having a great day or a bad day, whether it's raining in your heart or sunny in your heart, no matter what, your best friend is somebody you can count on. And that really was, I think, where St. Augustine was coming from. He'll tell us that we must have friends, because how could we really experience the joy of life without somebody to share that with? So for Augustine, it's very important that we have friends to share our lives with. He'll say to us that true friendship is rooted in God. You can't have a true friend unless that friendship is rooted in God, and unless both you and your friend bring each other to God. But the importance of friendship, nonetheless, is critical. In fact, I would say that for Augustine, it's a non-negotiable. Now, Augustine was a prolific writer. He wrote an awful lot. And whereas with St. Norbert, we have nothing from Norbert's hand. We have an enormous amount of writing from St. Augustine. And he wrote a whole treatise on friendship. And in his Confessions, he says, "The friendship which draws human beings together in a tender bond is sweet to us because out of many minds it forges a unity." So he speaks about friendship as forging a sweet bond. And then in a sadder moment, but I think a very eloquent moment, he says this, and I think it's profound. And when I teach my students about St. Augustine at Archmere, I always point to this passage from St. Augustine's Confessions. And this is about the loss of a friend, the death of a friend. But this is what he says. "I was amazed that other mortals went on living when he was dead, whom I loved, as though he would never die, and still more amazed that I could go on living myself when he was dead, I, who had been like another self to him. It was well said that a friend is half one's own soul. I felt that my soul and his had been but one soul in two bodies, and I shrank from life with loathing because I could not bear to be only half alive. And perhaps I was so afraid of death because I did not want the whole of him to die, whom I loved so dearly." So Augustine, who again, in many times in iconography, we see Augustine with the flaming heart. We don't see him necessarily in this rendering with the flaming heart, but we typically do. We see him with his friends, however, in these different parts of this beautiful piece of art. But we typically see Augustine with the flaming heart because Augustine was a passionate lover. And you just see in the way that he wrote about his friend that his friend and he shared, they were one soul in two bodies. And, you know, he didn't want to die after his friend died because he didn't want the part of his friend that was alive in him to die completely. Beautiful. Stunning, really, when you think about it. And today on this Feast of St. Augustine, it really is a day for us to celebrate our best friends. Those people that, because we're in a relationship with that person, a love relationship with that person, a part of them does live in us, and a part of us does live in them. And so it's really an opportunity for us to think about our friends, to pray for our friends, and to give thanks to God for the great gift of this life that God gives us to share it with our friends. I think of another scripture, an Old Testament scripture, and this from the first book of Samuel, the friendship between Jonathan and David. This was written way before St. Augustine wrote his Confessions, but I think in very much the same way speaks about this bond of friendship that is spoken about so beautifully. So they say of one another, "If I am still alive," this is Jonathan and David, "may you show me the kindness of the Lord. But if I die, never cut off your kindness from my house. And when the Lord cuts off all the enemies of David from the face of the land, the name of Jonathan must never be cut off from the family of David, or the Lord will make you answer for it." And in his love for David, Jonathan renewed his oath to him because he loved him as he loved himself. You know, these tender, beautiful words that speak about the power and the depth of friendship, we can never take that for granted. You know, when you're a kid, when you're a young kid, and I know this because I teach teenagers in high school, and I have for many years, we know if we reflect on our own teenage years and if we go through that with our own children or maybe our grandchildren, or if we're a teacher, we see it in the kids, their friend group is the most important group in their life. And as we grow up and as we mature, you know, our friends take a different place. Perhaps our spouse and our family becomes our the most important group in our lives, or for me, my religious community. But the value of friendship never wanes, never becomes less important. In fact, it becomes more important, because I think as we grow older and as we experience life together, I think the value and the importance of friendship grows even more in our lives, because there's also that great gift of wisdom and that great gift and experience of just being with another person and knowing that they know you inside out. There's another section just before Jonathan and David leave each other, and it says, David rose from beside the mound and fell on his face to the ground three times in homage of his friend Jonathan. They kissed each other and wept aloud together, because they were going to be separated. And so in Scripture and in the writings of St. Augustine, friendship is a great gift, and it's one that we can never take too lightly. So today, as we think about the great gift of friendship, ask yourself, who really are your friends? And who calls me friend? Do I ever take that for granted? Do I ever not honor the fact that somebody regards me as their friend, somebody with whom they can be themselves, somebody with whom they can be free to say, double my joy and divide my grief, you know? So on this Feast of St. Augustine, this great song by Queen comes to mind. And maybe today you can dedicate You're My Best Friend by Queen from 1975's A Night at the Opera to your best friend, maybe to your spouse, maybe to a childhood friend, to anyone. I don't think it just has to be one person. But so maybe you could say to a friend, or maybe even if you feel especially happy on this Feast of Augustine, maybe you could even sing it to them. You know, you make me live. Whenever this world is cruel to me, I got you to help me forgive. Ooh, you make me live. You're my best friend. When things turn out bad, you know I'll never be lonely. You're my only one, and I love the things. I really love the things that you do. You're my best friend. So call your friend, sing to your friend, and celebrate friendship today in the spirit of St. Augustine and in the spirit of our Lord, who through Samuel, the book of Samuel, and through the friendship of David and Jonathan, taught us the beauty and the necessity of friends. So if you have a friend, go celebrate them today and let them know that in them, they make you live. So live out loud with your friend, rock on, and play Queen, play it really loud, okay? Have a good day. You
content from the Spring House is available free of charge. If you find this ministry is of service to you, we hope that you will support us in providing this content in an ongoing manner. We consider this a pay-it-forward endeavor. Not only would your donation help us to cover the expenses of producing its content, you would make it possible for us to offer it to others as well. As long as we are able, by your generosity, we will continue to produce content which we believe will serve the church. We hope that you might become a partner in this ministry. Please click the link in the description below this video to make a donation.